We've been waiting for these.
Oh, the brows.
They're
big
phenomenal.
Customer pick. Mm-hmm. We've got them in the blonde. We've got it in the light brown and dark brown. It's $13. These are phenomenal.
Yeah, I mean, if you've got sparse, barely there brows and you don't want them to look painted on, this is an ultra fine tip. You can see it on Amy's hand as she's blending it in.
Look at that.
It gives you precise application, your evenly defined brows, and then there's a comb on the other side so you can comb them into place. I've been growing my brows out. If you've ever done it before, it is one of the most challenging and
annoying
things to try to do.
I didn't know there was such a thing. You were lucky you could even grow them out.
I'm Italian, so those of us who have that gene, we tend to have the ability to grow our brows out very easily. But you know what? It's changed. It's really helped me do that because I can fill in where I need those spots.
Well, if you want to grow out your brows or whether you don't have them, we're going to show you how to get them coming up right after we check with Leslie in our spotlight.
I'm so proud of my heritage, and it means so much to me. We here at HSN are honored to be part of Hispanic Heritage Month. Join us September 15th through October 15th as we celebrate the heritage, culture, family, and traditions of Hispanic personalities such as Taya's very own Patricia Velasquez, Chef Eduardo Garcia's Montana Mex, Crafty Chica Kathy Cano Murillo, Chef Lorena Garcia, and so many more, all sharing stories and inspirations that shape them into the successful individuals they are today. And don't miss out on exciting launches with Larissa Barrera and Boem, along with special guest, fashion expert Kika Rocha, and Chef Alfredo Oropesa. Come celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month with us, and you can always visit hsn.com. Just search Hispanic Heritage Month and read some of HSN's own family members' inspirational stories. Ahí nos vemos.
Is this universal thing that we all love, right? It doesn't matter where you come from, how old you are, what you look like, everyone's gotta eat. It's this one universal thing that we all can share together. And then to share with others the solutions that are working for me, can't think of a better job. I love teaching people how to cook. Those tips and tools and techniques that they're gonna use in their kitchen will hopefully bring them more happiness, joy, and better food experiences.
My singular goal is to improve the quality of people's lives. Everything we do is intended to be unlike any other company of our kind. We just make exceptional vitamins so you could have exceptional health. It's not important that you get the products I'm offering, but it's very important that you get the information I'm sharing, because information is the key to being a healthy person.
Well, we're back. We just had a huge brow debate going on with Robert. Because, you know, we're all talking about big brows are in. Yes, they are. But they have to be proportioned to our face.
Right, exactly.
And so we just had a big debate about that. And so what's nice is we do have the brow expert joining us, Robert, with the best brow pencil. These always sell out. You have light to choose from here, brown or dark brown. It's $26 value, two credit card payments of $13. We have about 2,000 for the entire world, and that's it. You can't make these fast enough.
No, every time we come here, we sell them out. We can't keep them in stock, so I'm so glad we got these for you today. If you've got sparse, barely there brows, and you're filling them in, and you don't want them to look painted on, this is gonna give you an ultra fine tip. So when you put them on, you'll get precise application. It's going to look like just little hairs that are evenly defined. And then you're going to notice that there's a comb on the other side, so you can comb them into place. We do have three shades, blonde, brown, and dark brown. Robert's going to walk you through the shades so that you know exactly what to pick up, and he's going to share tips too. So if you want to fill those brows in and get everything to look perfect, just like Amy's brows.
Oh, stop it. Thank you. Blonde will be the first to sell out because I said my brows, I think, are too thick.
That was our
big debate. I said, they're too big, they're too bushy. And he's like, no, Amy. But here's the best tip he just shared with me. He's like, do not pluck your brows unless you have them filled.
Correct.
What? Now, explain why that's important.
Well, because if you're filling in your brow, well, let's just go to, come to my hand first. We have some time. All right, so this is the blonde, this is the brown, and this is the dark brown. So you can see, you get a really precise little fine edge. So you can create those little fine hairs. So maybe you don't need a whole filled in brow. You just need a little edge put back into your brow.
Mm-hmm.
So you get that perfect little precise point. That's what's so great with these pencils. They're so easy to work with. And they're twist up so you don't have to worry about a sharpener. All right, the reason you always want to do when you tweeze or pluck, as some people call them, you always want to do that with something in your brow.
And I suggest never doing that alone.
Always do it with something in your brow.
The reason being, or something in your brow.
This way, you fill the brow, you see what you're working with, and now you can take out hairs that aren't in the scope of what you've just drawn on. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Because then you're tweezing blindly if you're doing it with nothing on your brow.
Look at Stacy's brow.
The other thing is, this is Stacy's lower brow, but now it doesn't look lower, does it?
No, what do you mean it's her lower brow? Oh, because they're sisters or they're cousins, not sisters.
Yeah, well, they're sisters, not twins, but we want to make them look like they have the same father. So always start.
We just got from bad to even worse.
So you want to always start with your weaker brow. All of us have one brow that's a little weaker than the other. So start with the lower brow.
And it all revolves around Stacy and the brows. But you know, one thing, look at these small strokes.
Yeah.
If you don't have a very, very fine point, you have got to have that fine point, especially when you've got very small, narrow, arched brows. Look how precise Stacy's brows are. You can't have a big tip on that because then it's not applying precisely where you need them, and then you end up overdrawing. But then there's the tool on the end that blends it into the brow and grabs it on, giving you that 24-hour long wear, and that is the most perfect blonde. The most hands-down perfect blonde shade.
It's so soft. It's just a really perfect color. It's not too yellow. It's not too orangey. It's not too red.
Wow.
You know, some of the blonde colors on the market are really, ooh, you see those brows coming a mile away. You know, the big, heavy, overdone brow, hallelujah, it's gone.
Obviously, brows are a sensitive point, sensitive area.
He feels very strongly about brows.
I can see this,
he does.
Okay.
Well, you know, because I think of brows as brows are supposed to be the frame, not the artwork. And for so long, you see all these tutorials. Now, here's a perfect example. This brow's a little bit lower than this brow. So you always wanna start with the lower brow first so that you can pick this one back up. If you did this one first, you would lift this one automatically.
Oh.
And then when you get to this one, what are you gonna do? You gotta draw it way above.
Good point.
So start with the lower brow. Here's a little trick. Comb them down first, the little hairs. Find where you need your angle. We know the brow should start where the nose and the tear duct is.
Okay.
It should end here at the angle. Okay, so we know we need to extend it a little bit. Your arch should be right over your pupil from your nose. Okay? So if that's your angle, we're gonna make a little point right here, a little dot, and that's where we're gonna head Carol's brow to get over that extra little lift. And I'm just gonna make those nice little fine hairs.
Last call on blonde. If you want that blonde, you've gotta be ordering. It's only $13. Are you using blonde or brown on her?
This is the brow.
Okay.
So Stacey had the blonde. Carol, we're getting the brown.
I have the blonde on.
But look at how much lift that just gave that one eye. Now, if you want to get a little bit more lift, this is going to sound weird. I'm going to go lower here so that it appears the arch is higher. So it makes the angle of the arch much more lifted.
Oh, I see that.
So it brings the eye up.
Wow.
So then on this eye, I don't have to work as hard. This is where, you know.
So start off with the problem child eye first is what you're saying, and then go to the next one. Okay, again, we are very busy. It's a customer pick. This was only saved for us tonight. And that's it. You're not going to see this later on. So if you are brow challenged, I think a lot of us are, we've either overplucked or how blessed is Cara that she can say, oh, you know what, Amy, I'm going to go ahead and grow my brows out.
Well, you know what? I got overdone. Like the people who worked on my brows and I did it myself, I just kept tweezing and tweezing and tweezing and tweezing, and they got so thin that they didn't fit my face shape like Robert's telling all of us that they have to fit your features.
They are absolutely
stunning. So I started growing. Thank you.
Do you have anything filled
in? I have just a little bit of the brown. I'm still trying to grow in right here and right here. So you can see there's a little bit, if you come in on me, you'll see that there's a little bit in here.
Look at that gorgeous brow.
And a little bit here. I think I'm pointing in the right spot because that's still where I'm sparse, and I'm still sparse a little bit in here. So I'm just using it to fill in just those areas, but I still look like I have natural brows.
Wow.
And it's been a rough time trying to grow
Cara,
them out.
It's gorgeous.
But it makes a difference. Thank you.
That's the whole point. But when you have the right product, it makes the biggest difference.
Yes.
And again, a lot of times you're seeing the brow pencils and all this gel and all these other, you put on too much.
Right.
Or it's not precise enough and you can't get the right angle that you want. This is what I love that we have Robert here doing for us, because you get that exact application. It stays all day long. And start off, like you said, with the one that's maybe the little awkward one that you need to fill in a little bit more, but it's the strokes that you use and the precision that you get from this tip. You're not pressing down hard. There's no pulling. There's no tugging. The little spoolies at the end. Read some of the reviews on hsn.com. I'm glad you're picking them up. Again, Blonde will be the first to sell out, and this is your only chance for Lancome's visit. There's only one more show tonight to pick up our today's special, and that's it. These are gone. You're not going to be seeing our today's special ever again. But again, the brows, even these are always sold out at counter.
These are such a winning product because they're so easy to use. They're really goof-proof. You don't have to work hard with these. Just brush those little individual strokes on and bring back that natural shape of your brow. Look at the confidence that that gives that one eye compared to the other, how much more lift it gave. That's what I love about these. So easy to work with.
All right, I'm glad you're ordering yours. Again, last call on that Blonde. So we do have the Blonde. We also have this in brown.